Yeah, so what's the prize we're gonna get for learning this poem?
Learning. Yeah. Knowing how to read something and understand it is the prize, okay? Knowing how to think is the prize.
I know how to think right now.
Okay, well, yeah, well, you know how to run, too, but not the way you could run if you trained. You know, the mind is like a muscle, okay? And if you want it to be really powerful, you gotta work it out, okay? Each new fact gives you another choice. Each new idea builds another muscle, okay? And it's those muscles that are gonna make you really strong. Those are your weapons.
I have one final project in mind.
Miss G wanted us to put our diaries together in a book, just like Anne Frank. She got this businessman, John Tu, to donate 35 computers so we could work. She told us we had something to say to people. We weren't just kids in a class anymore. We were writers with our own voices, our own stories, and even if nobody else read it, the book would be something to leave behind that said we were here. This is what happened. We mattered. Even if it was just to each other. And we won't forget. Miss G didn't promise it would get published or anything, but we could get it out there ourselves. She asked us to come up with a title. Something to call ourselves.
Miss Lang.
I meant for the day. School's out, Miss Lang. I meant give it up for the day.
I know what you meant.
Then why are you crying?
I'm terrible. I'm terrible, Mr. Rowland. I practiced and my lips swell up.
Miss
It takes a lot of work to
learn a musical instrument.
I just want to be good at something.
So, I just wanted to say thanks. Thanks for trying.
Is it any fun?
I wanted it to be.
You know what we've been doing wrong, Miss Lang? We've been playing the notes on the page.
Well, what else is there to play?
Well, there's a lot more to music than notes on a page. These guys, for example. Now, they can't sing, and they have absolutely no harmonic sense, and they're playing the same three chords over and over again. And I love it. Do you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Why?
I don't know.
Yeah, you do.
Because it's fun?
That's right. Because playing music is supposed to be fun. It's about heart. It's about feelings and moving people and something beautiful and being alive, and it's not about notes on a page. I could teach you notes on a page. I can't teach you that other stuff.
Oh.
All right, no, don't do that. Let me ask you a question.
What?
When you look in the mirror, what do you like best about yourself?
My hair.
Why?
My father always says that it reminds him of a sunset.
Play the sunset.
Now, who's next? Mr. Anderson, so you're sitting there in agony. Come on, Todd, step up. Let's put you out of your misery.
I didn't do it. I didn't write a poem.
Mr. Anderson thinks that everything inside of him is worthless and embarrassing. Isn't that right, Todd? And that's your worst fear. Well, I think you're wrong. I think you have something inside of you that is worth a great deal. I sound my barbaric yelp. The rooftops. World. W. Uncle Walt again. Now, for those of you who don't know, a yelp is a loud cry or yell. Now, Todd, I would like you to give us a demonstration of a barbaric yelp. Come on, you can't yelp sitting down. Let's go. Come on, up. Gotta get in yelping stance.
A yelp.
No, not just a yelp, a barbaric yelp.
Yelp.
Come on, louder.
Yelp.
Oh, that's a mouse. Come on, louder.
Yelp.
Oh, good God, boy, yell like
yelp. There it is.
You see, you have a barbarian in you after all. Now, you don't get away that easy. Picture of Uncle Walt up there. What does he remind you of? Don't think. Answer. Go on.
A madman.
What kind of madman? Don't think about it. Just answer again.
A crazy madman.
Oh, you can do better than that. Free up your mind. Use your imagination. Say the first thing that pops into your head, even if it's total gibberish. Go on.
A sweaty tooth madman.
Good God, boy, there's a poet in you after all. There, close your eyes. Close your eyes. Close them. Now, describe what you see.
I close my eyes.
Yes?
And this image floats beside me.
The sweaty tooth madman.
The sweaty tooth madman with a stare that pounds my brain.
Oh, that's excellent. Now, give him action. Make him do something.
His hands reach out and choke me.
That's wonderful, wonderful.
And all the time he's mumbling.
What's he mumbling?
Mumbling truth.
Yeah, yeah.
Truth like a blanket that always leaves your feet cold.
Forget them, forget them. Stay with the blanket. Tell me about that blanket.
You push it, stretch it, it'll never be enough. You kick at it, beat it, it'll never cover any of us. From the moment we enter crying to the moment we leave dying, it'll just cover your face as you wail and cry and scream.